Okay, everybody, today we are going to put our own custom 3D object in our scene. This is from the last tutorial where we made a river and sculpted things out. What I want to do is right on this beach, I'm going to put a welcome sign. So to do that, we're going to go into Blender. If you've never used Blender before, well, it's not that hard and it's free. It doesn't cost a single thing to use it other than time and knowledge. Okay, so this is what it looks like when you open up Blender right from the get-go, and we use the middle mouse button to sort of wander around. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to really quickly create something. So select the cube, hit X to delete, shift A, and we're going to create mesh, and we'll go with a cylinder. Now we have to keep in mind that Unreal Engine makes the characters at 1.78 centimeters or units. So 178 centimeters is what the character is. So in here, these characters way over here, these little spawning dudes are 178 centimeters in units that we can use in Blender. So this object here is sitting at a depth of 2 meters. So it's a height of 2 meters. That's about right. I think a 2 meter sign would be pretty good. The radius is pretty big. So we're just going to bring the pole. This is going to be the pole of the sign. We're going down to 0.1, and we'll bring the vertices down to 16 or something. And that will be our pole. Yeah, just like that. Now, the problem with this right off the bat for Unreal Engine is that the origin point is right in the center. So if we select this and hit Tab, what we want to do is we want to bring it all the way up to the level plane of the world. So we'll hit GZ1, and that will move it up just perfect, right into the center there. So every one unit inside a Blender is 1 meter by default. So now we've got our 2 meter post. We've got it sitting right on the ground, which is theoretically our ground. So for example, if we brought in a plane, it would place it on the ground. Anyways, we don't want that. So yeah, Control Z. All right, now the next thing we want to do is we want to make a bit of a sign. So while I'm still in this edit mode for cylinder, I'm just going to go Shift A, and we'll bring in a cube, right? And we'll go scale Y. So let's make it just slightly bigger, and scale Z, bring that down, GZ up here. I kind of want to make it a bit of a post that looks like that. And then let's put a little more geometry in this. We'll go, Control B to give it just a little bit of a bevel. That's kind of nice. And then we'll hit Alt while we select one of these vertices up top. And we can just move in Control B for that as well, just to make it look a little cleaner. All right, something like that is good. All right, so Tab out. So that'll take us out of edit mode for this object, because next thing we want to do is add some text. So we'll go Shift A and select text, and that will create some text on the ground. We can go Tab. We'll erase all that. Let's put welcome with an exclamation mark. That's pretty good. Tab again to come out of edit mode, and G to grab, Z for up, and then we'll go rotate X 90, and let's see, let's scale this down a smidge, and we'll come into front view by hitting 1 on the numpad, and we'll just move this guy over somewhere to there, scale it down a smidge more there, scale it down a little more there, and just a little bit more. Okay, that's where I want it to be. Now we're going to keep in mind that these are two separate objects right now, so it actually doesn't really matter where we put it, but we're just going to place it in the right place in case we were to ever pass this asset on. So we'll move it in the y-axis to bring it outside of the sign, because right now it was in the middle, and then we'll go over to our text tool And I'm just going to quickly add a little geometry to it. So we'll set, we'll extrude it, I don't know, 0.0, no, let's go 0.1 of a meter. And we will also give this a bit of a bevel as well. So maybe 0.02. Let's take a look at what that looks like. That doesn't look too bad. All right, so G wide, just sort of embedded in the sign. See if we like it. I like it. I think that looks good. And shade auto smooth, so just sort of smooths things out. Okay, so now that we've got that done, I'm just going to quickly color it. So I'm going to make the sign. Let's go into materials, hit new. Let's make it sort of a dark brown. So just come down to here, something like that. That's pretty good, I think. Just to see that, we'll change our view over to that. And then let's make these letters really stand out. So I'm going to make them maybe like a bright yellow. That looks pretty good. Yeah. All right. So now that that's done, we've made our thing that we want to put into Unreal Engine, right? So we want to put a thing in here. All right. So go to File, Export, FBX. And then we'll just pick a place to send this to. I've got my Fortnite projects here. So I'm going to put welcome sign. Like that. And just export the FBX. Just like that. So now that that's done, we can minimize Blender. And I'm going to grab my my Explorer window. So here's my Explorer window. It says welcome sign just sitting inside here. So that's good. Now we want to go into our content drawer, and inside the content drawer, you're going to see all. So just close this. You're going to see all, and then whatever your project name is, content, Fortnite, and Epic. So inside of ours, we're going to create a folder called My Assets or My Models or whatever you want to do. Inside of My Assets, you can even make another one called Models. And that's where we put it. I'm just going to put everything in My Assets for now. So what we do is we take our folder, we just take this FBX file and just drag it straight into this big, huge window here. And it'll ask you some stuff, just import everything. Okay, so now we have a content browser that'll show up. Like when you import something, it'll immediately show it to you because Unreal Engine thinks you want to use it right away, which we kind of do. So here we've got our sign. We're just going to take this out and drag it to there. Look at that. Just like that. So let's see. Let's hit the E key, and I'm going to rotate this. Let's see. Let's put this, yeah. So W to move it, and a little bit up. I'm just going to put it up on the top of the hill here. And make sure to stick it in the ground. Otherwise, it'll look funny. Like, what's going on with the sign? Doesn't look right. That's not bad. Let's see. Let's bring it up just a smidge. Just so it just sits kind of tall. Just like that. And that's how you bring in your own stuff into Unreal Engine for Fortnite. And then if we want to see this in real time, we'll go ahead and we'll save this, right? And then we can launch our session. It'll ask us to save again. So save that. And it's going to open up Fortnite. Okay, so Fortnite is loading up. We're connecting up to our map that was uploaded to Fortnite servers. And it should load in everything that we've done, which is simply our river on our landscape with our new welcome sign. And this is really powerful because it means that you can create all kinds of things that can be inside of your Fortnite game that aren't in anybody else's Fortnite game. And Blender is really powerful. You can create a lot of stuff inside of Blender, and it's totally free. Doesn't cost a thing. Neither does Unreal Engine. Doesn't cost anything. Okay, so we are in the game. I happen to be... right now, I happen to be Wolverine, so I'm just going to step off of here. We'll take a look, and there's our welcome sign. Look at that. We can even jump on top of it if we wanted to. So, that's how you bring in assets from outside of Fortnite that aren't already in there. If you want to build something, you can just use Blender to do it, and you should be good to go. Any questions, let me know, and I'll see you in the next one.